Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. So yesterday we done the i'rab of the harf jar zaid. Yes? Now today we're going to do the i'rab of harf jar shabihum bi zaid. So harf jar zaida is what? What's harf jar zaid? What is it? Harf jar zaida? Pardon me? Min and ba. Why is it zaid? It's used for emphasis. Yeah, correct. But the why is that? Why do they call it zaid? It's two things. There's no muta'allaq, number one. And number two, what? It doesn't give any new meaning. It only gives the meaning of emphasis. Okay? So za'ida, the huruf jar za'ida, give no new meaning and has no muta'allaq. Shabihum bi za'id means what? It's similar to za'id. What does that mean? That it has a new meaning, but it has no muta'allaq. Correct? What are these? Rubba. Hasha, khala, and ada. We then is already in bidqi. So you have rubba means many. So for example, rubba talin yal'anuhu al-Quran. Many a reciter. The Quran curses him for not reciting the Quran properly or not for fulfilling the Quranic rites. Hasha, khala, and ada, they are all like illa. So they have no muta'alliq. They give new meaning. Rubba gives a new meaning, many. Khala, hasha, ada give new meaning except like illa. But they have no muta'allaq. They're not linked to anything. Are you following? That's why they're shabihum bi zaid. Not zaid, totally. Like ba and min, which have no new meaning. They are shabihum bi zaid. They're similar to zaid because they have no muta'allaq, but they give a new meaning. How do you tarkib of this? You will say rubba is harfu jar shabihum bi zaid. Rubba, harfu jar, but shabihum bi zaid. And a kitabin is majroor, but it's mubtada. And khabar is qara'tuhu. Many books I have read, or many a book I have read. Do you understand? Are you following me?
This one has a new meaning, but
no muta'allaq. That's why you don't have to make it jar majroor muta'allaq to anything. That's why it's not majroor. You see, it's majroor in terms of i'rab, but it's not a link to anything. Not jar majroor muta'alliqani bi something. Are you following me? So rubba is the harf jar shabihun bi zaid, mubtada and khabar. So for example, say rubba, harfu jar shabihun bi zaid, and kitabin is majroorun bil kasra lafzan. Same as yesterday. It's majroorun bil kasra, lafzan is majroor. But mahalna, what is it? Marfu'. Why? Because it's becoming what? Mubtada. Make sense? Yes? Similarly, khala and hasha are the same i'rab. Ja'at tullab khala zaidin. So fa'il fa'il. Khala harfu jar shabihun bi zaid. You say zaidin is mustathna. So mustasna is mansub. So what do you say here? Ja fa'lun madhi mabniun lil fath. Tullab, you know the i'rab. Khala harfu jar shabihun bi zaid. Zaid is majrurun bil kasrati lafzan. Cuz khala makes it majrur. But mahallan is mansub cuz mustasna is what? Mansub. To mahallan, what is it? Mansub. Are you following me? Do you understand that? Yes? Okay. Subhanallah, bihamdi, subhanakallahumma, bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, wa astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.